Look, the Pakistani bowling attack is much better than the Indian bowling attack, because Pakistan has just taken twice 20 wickets in against England, which is now the number one team. So Indian batting would be better, but Pakistan seems to be clicking very well as a unit now. I mean, Pakistan's recent performances have been very, very encouraging. I don't really remember all the bowling I did, that was so long ago. But I can say one thing, that Sunil Gavaskar, his wicket was always special. And the reason was, Sunil Gavaskar had one of the best defensive techniques I had ever seen of a cricketer. And judging by what India has achieved, it's not easy what India has achieved. 8 losses in a row in test matches, it's very difficult. They could have done with a Sunil Gavaskar's batting technique, because he had the best defensive technique. And so whenever you got his wicket, you knew you really had bowled a good delivery.
Mr. Imran, I'm A.K. Siddiqui from Herald, Rasitic Herald and the Eastern Post, Calcutta. It's weekly. There were news that you would form an alliance with Parvez Musharraf, but you seem to be against any alliance, what you have said a little while back. Could I know one? This is question number one, please.
Look, Parvez Musharraf is not even in Pakistan.
Yeah.
So how can you make an alliance with someone who's not even in...
Great. Thank you very much. The other question is that I'll tell you a little small poem in Urdu, which is a question by Jaan Nisar Akhtar, Javed Akhtar's father. Zindagi tanha safar ki raat hai. Zindagi tanha safar ki raat hai. Apne apne hausle ki baat hai. Zindagi tanha safar ki raat hai. Apne apne hausle ki baat hai. Kis aqeedah ki duhai dijiye. Har aqeedah aaj be-aukaat hai. Kya pata kab pahunchenge manzil talak. Ghatte badhte faaslon ka saath hai. Ghatte badhte faaslon ka saath hai. Aap apna faasla tehreek-e-insaaf ke zariye ya apne party ke followers ke zariye. Aapko 20 seat mila tha guzishta parliamentary seat. Is baar aapka organizational strength kya hai aur kitne log aap ummeed karte hain kitne seat hasil karenge inshallah taala, iska jawab dein please.
Urdu mein dekhe do tarike hain election ladne ke. Ek tarika hai constituency politics, power politics karke, aur dusra tarika hai ek movement ke zariye election ladna. Main kabhi bhi meri party aur main इतना ताकतवर स्टेटस को का कभी हम मुकाबला कर ही नहीं सकते थे उनकी पिच के ऊपर, यानी कि कंस्टिट्यूएंसी पॉलिटिक्स कर. हम सिर्फ एक ही तरह जीत सकते थे, एक तहरीक या एक मूवमेंट चला के. वो मूवमेंट आ चुकी है, और इसलिए मैं आपको कह रहा हूं कि जो हमारी मूवमेंट है वो कैंडिडेट को वोट नहीं पड़ेगी, वो पार्टी के टिकट को वोट पड़ेगी. और जब पार्टी के टिकट को वोट पड़ेगी तभी वो तब्दीली ला सकती, नहीं तो फिर आप कैंडिडेट्स के गुलाम बन जाते हैं.
मेरी मुनीर है, मटियावज कलकत्ता का रहने वाला हूँ, उम्र करीब 62 साल और लिखाई पढ़ाई से कुछ मतलब. कहना सर कि मुख्तलिफ पार्टियाँ यहाँ पर आईं और पाकिस्तान में भी आईं, और उन्होंने हिंदुस्तान से दोस्ती की बात की लेकिन ना मुकम्मल रही. मैं उम्मीद करता हूँ कि आपकी पार्टी अगर आएगी तो क्या हिंदुस्तान से मुकम्मल दोस्ती आप करेंगे, ताकि यहाँ के और वहाँ के लोग मिलकर के एक मोहब्बत का नया असम्बली का रास्ता निकालें.
देखिए जी, अगर हमने अपनी आवाम को ये बता दिया कि दोस्ती से इस सारे बर्रे सगीर को कितना फ़ायदा हो सकता है, तो आवाम क्यों नहीं चाहेगी दोस्ती. असल में आवाम दोस्ती चाहती है. जो लीडरशिप है 9/11, असामा बिन लादन वॉज इन अफगानिस्तान, सो वॉज अलकायदा, सो वॉज तालिबान. No Pakistani was involved in those 9/11 attacks. What did we have to do with it?
How would you react to this observation that you sound like any other Pakistani politician, whether a Rahman Malik or a Yusuf Raza Gilani?
No, I don't care how I sound like. I'm just giving you facts. These are just undisputed facts that Pakistan had nothing to do with 9/11. And if if it was Al-Qaeda, it was in Afghanistan, fact. Militant Taliban, Afghanistan, fact. Any Pakistani involved in those attacks? None, fact. So what is there to dispute about this?
The lady there, you to start exploring religion more deeply in the late 80s when the book burning happened. And you said that the Islamic leadership ought to have been able to convince the West that the love that Muslims have for the Prophet is so great, and you need to be as sensitive to it as the Jews, the Jewish leadership in a similar situation sort of were able to put across the message that you must not trivialize or deny the Holocaust. But is there a parallel to be drawn between a Holocaust which cost 6 million lives and, say, a novel which has cost no lives?
First of all, what is painful for a human community? Only that human community should decide. So, who is to say that for a Muslim, probably it is even much more painful than the Holocaust is for the Jews? Who is to decide that? I, as a Muslim, am telling you that the ultimate insult or ultimate pain you can inflict to a Muslim is abuse the Prophet. Because the Prophet for us is the witness to the Quran. And Quran is a book of guidance. Most Muslims live their religions. So for them, whereas you cannot compare 6 million Jews being killed as they were, and you can't compare, Salman Rushdie writing what we felt was humiliating our Prophet. But what is painful? When you're talking about a human community, the idea is that a human community should live peacefully with each other. The ideological founding father was Iqbal, in my opinion, one of the greatest Islamic scholars in the last 500 years. And the political role model was Jinnah. And your great leader was Gandhi. I've quoted in the book what Gandhi said, and what Jinnah has said, what Iqbal has said. Basically, they looked upon religion not as some sort of a theocracy, but religion was the alternative to materialism. So what you're seeing in the West was predicted by the great Iqbal. He always said that a civilization which does not have the religious, for them, humane values, will end up becoming totally materialistic. So there are two different worldviews. One is the religious worldview, which is a humane, all religions say the same thing, all religions. They talk about two things, justice and humanity, being human, what is called Khilafat-e Rashida. It was the first time a state took responsibility of the widows, about the orphans, about the handicapped, gave money to the poor. So the first ever welfare state came about then. So now, unfortunately, we look at our country, it is the ultimate predatory state. Poor get poorer and the rich get richer. Whereas in Europe, and my model, so if Scandinavian countries were Muslims, there would be a totally Islamic state. Because in the Scandinavian countries, I see total welfare, I see justice, I see...
Hello, Mr. Khan. You said that it took Pakistani people about 8 or 10 years to realize what you had said, that corruption is the main cause of bad governance. So, are you seeing that you'll give leadership which you need to guide Pakistan to the past glories which it once had?
Look, whichever country, we've seen two countries take off in the past 10 years, which were really in the doldrums. One is Turkey, the other is Brazil. Look at Turkey and Brazil right now. If you saw them 10 years back, they were nowhere. And then around us, we have seen Singapore, we have seen Malaysia. In front of us, they've taken off. I mean, the principles in all these countries are the same. Number one, clean government. Clean government means the prime minister and his cabinet. If you want to win the war, you must address the causes which lead to terrorism. So by just saying, by blaming religion and finding some sort of a cure in moderate Islam means that you are applying the wrong medicine. So if there is a problem in Pakistan-India problem, the cure lies in politics, not in some sort of moderate Islam. If the Americans wanted to end this, find out what happened in 9/11, why did 9/11 happen? It did not happen because of radical Islam. It happened because of the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. They were all Arabs who felt that the US foreign policy is lopsided. It's the foreign policy that needed to be corrected. As long as it is not corrected, this is not going to end. If Israel and Palestinian have an issue, Israel can keep saying that this is some Hamas is some radical Muslim organization. And they will keep killing people. But it's not going to end the problem. Problem will be eventually a political settlement.
Okay. I'll answer yours. Fundamentalists in every country should be treated the same way. And you know how? Intellectually. You never fight fundamentalism with guns because you drive them into militants. You should always fight.
Copy.